When creating objects in CorelDRAW, you don't have to rely on just your eyes to place things where you want them. With smart drawing tools like guidelines, alignment and positioning options, and live guides, every object can easily go just where it should. We'll look at three dockers that have all the options you'll need for aligning and positioning objects. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also download a written copy of this tutorial. First, let's look at guidelines. I have this template open with 8 dashed blue lines. These are guidelines. In my Objects Docker, I can see that these guidelines are on the Master Page layer, where I could turn them off and on with the eye icon. Because blue guidelines are hard to see against this blue background, I can select them all and right-click on the pink swatch to change their color. The Guidelines Docker is one place where I can create guidelines. The ones I already have are listed here, 4 horizontal and 4 vertical. I can use this icon to turn them on and off, and here I can set a different line style and color for the guidelines I'm about to create. If I want to place a new horizontal guideline to mark the top of the light blue box, I'll set the drop-down to Horizontal. I'll enter the Y distance of 0.8 and click Add. It's not where I want it though, so I'll select the guideline, change the Y dimension to 0.855, and click Modify. I could also select this guideline and press Ctrl-D to copy it, then move it by dragging or by entering an exact distance. Or I can create a guideline by dragging from the ruler into the document, then modify its placement if needed. For an angled guideline, I'll choose that option from the drop-down. I'll create it using the previous X and Y values, then enter an angle. Now I'll move it into place along this line in the document. I'll make a copy of this guideline, move it a bit, and when I click again on this line, I can rotate it. I'll continue moving and rotating until I have this guideline where I need it. If I want to be sure that my guidelines won't be moved or deleted, I can select them all and lock them. When Snap to Guidelines is enabled, I can reference these guidelines while creating objects. For example, I could use the Pen tool to trace this shape. New in CorelDRAW 2021, any custom guidelines you create are now listed in the Guidelines Docker. In this example, my final product will have an elliptical border. So I'll start with an ellipse and use the Objects Docker to move this shape into the Guides layer. Now in the Guidelines Docker, the ellipse appears as a custom guideline with the guideline color, and I could easily lock or delete it. I'll use this guide to mark the border for my objects, then hide all guides. When a drawing is created using a scale, guidelines can reflect drawing units or real-world units. In this example, there are several guidelines whose locations are set according to the current drawing units of millimeters. Because the scale is 1 to 175, I'll open Layout, Document Options, and on the Rulers tab, I'll click Edit Scale. Here I can set a custom scale of 1 drawing millimeter equals 175 real-world millimeters. Now the drawing units reflect real-world units, but the guidelines still use drawing units. So I'll click the Options icon and choose Show at Scale, and the guideline locations update to real-world units. Next, let's look at the Align and Distribute Docker, where I have all of these placement options in one convenient place. If I want these four groups to line up neatly with one another, I can select them all and click Align Center Vertically or Align Top. To space them evenly, I'll click Distribute Center Horizontally. Distribution is to the selected objects, so the first and last objects remain in place, and the rest have evenly spaced center lines. Or I can switch to Page Edge and Distribute Space Horizontally, and now the objects take up the entire width of the page and have identical spaces in between. I have several other alignment options, such as Page Edge, Page Center, or I can specify a point. I can enter coordinates or click Specify Point to pick a point directly on the document. With this point set, I can click Align Bottom to bring all groups down to that horizontal level. Finally, let's look at the Live Guides Docker. When alignment guides are enabled, I have several alignment options to choose from. For example, if Object Edges is enabled, I can create shapes that align with existing edges. With Intelligent Spacing, I can draw shapes spaced exactly between two shapes. And with Intelligent Dimensioning, I can scale an object and get indicators when a dimension is matched with an existing object. Or I can rotate an object to match the same rotation angle as an existing object. With dynamic guides enabled, I can choose the angles I want to be able to snap to. As I move my cursor around, the various angled guidelines appear, and I can even use guideline intersections when placing objects. If I want angles other than the standard ones that appear here, I can create a custom angle. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on aligning and positioning objects. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also download a written copy of this tutorial.